Dear friends, welcome to this edition of Osteology Lectures VBS Osteomed on YouTube, a series of e-learning videos on osteology. The topic today is skull, Norma, lateralis, part 1. The face zone. When you look at the norma lateralis, it is in two parts. One is the lateral view of the skull, and below that, the lateral view of the mandible. But for discussion purposes, we will add or subtract the mandible as required, because the mandible blocks the view of regions like infratemporal fossa. Now, this may probably be a better view. The mandible has been removed, and this may give a more clearer picture of the details of norma lateralis. We will add mandible as required. Now let's divide the norma lateralis into three zones: an anterior, a middle, and a posterior zone, like this. In other words, it's nothing but face, temporal zone, and occipital zone. Now you see, let's study the face zone of norma lateralis in a little detail. Incidentally, we have already covered this in the norma frontalis video. However, if you are looking at this video for the first time without a preview of the frontalis video, then it may be slightly difficult. Therefore, what I will do is we will try to identify the bones. We will also add another photograph where a little of the frontalis is also is visible. That improves the clarity in the understanding. Now we see that's the frontal bone, the upper flashing arrow. The lower flashing arrow is the zygomatic bone or the cheek bone. Now we see this anterolateral view adds more meaning to the discussion. The same bones are being identified on the other side. Similarly, in front the nasal bone, and lower down the two flashing arrows, the maxilla can be identified. The circles, non-flashing blue and white circle, are the orbital openings, or as we particularly call it, anterior orbital opening. The piriform aperture or the anterior nasal aperture is shown on both the photographs with a flashing arrow. Likewise, a central elevation, the glabella, below that junction of two sutures, the nasion. Actually, it's a junction point between the internasal and frontonasal sutures. It's an important junction point. Next, lateral extensions of the glabella, that elevation in the middle, when extended laterally, it forms the superciliary arch. Then below it, the supraorbital margin. The non-flashing arrows refer to the supraorbital margin. Likewise, at the lateral part of the orbital opening, we can see the lateral orbital margin, and also forming that margin is the frontal process of zygomatic, the flashing arrow there. And right above it, you can see the frontozygomatic suture. Let me see. I have slightly expanded the view, anterior and lateral view, the face part, and then a little of the next area, the temporal region. Since we have got the orientation, I am reducing the other photograph, the anterolateral view. You can see the flashing arrow is the anterior nasal spine at the lower border of the piriform aperture. We can also see the alveolar process of the maxilla, which holds the upper dentition. Although the teeth are not there in the skull, that's the alveolar sockets for the upper dentition. Next, to complete the features, along the supraorbital margin is the supraorbital notch, or more often a foramen. Likewise, on the floor, just below the inferior orbital margin on the maxilla, is the infraorbital foramen. Although strictly not a part of this view, but then visible in this view, more on a posterior plane on the other, that is the medial wall of the orbit, are seen the curved arrow, the lacrimal bone, a small leaf-like bone, and the flashing arrow is the frontal process of the maxilla. It is included in the discussion because it is still visible in Norma lateralis. Next, I told you we'll add mandible as and when required. Let's do it now. Once the mandible is added, we can see the mental foramen, and more in the midline, in the sagittal plane, the mental protuberance. Likewise, the ramus of the mandible, that is the extension, posterosuperior extension from the body of the mandible, it ends in two processes, an anterior coronoid process and a posterior condylar process. Any feedback on this video, kindly send in your comments either to this email ID, or there is a blog area right below the video on YouTube. You can add your comments there. That was a presentation from the Anatomy Department of St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, India. Just like this series, there is also another series of videos, VBS Histomed. This is a set of videos, about 90 plus videos, for MBBS, medical, dental, nursing, physiotherapy, and allied courses. Thank you.